Welcome back to Art Lessons at Home with the Art Groupies. Today's lesson is brought to you by DC. DC is short for Developing Craft, and she's going to talk about developing great art habits to be a better artist. So, welcome DC. You always want to get into the habit of taking care of your art space. Clean up and put away all of your art supplies. Therefore, you know where they are when you come back. The second thing that DC always practices, is practice. Practice, practice. To get good at being an artist and developing your craft, you need to take a skill and work at it and get better. So, thank you, DC. The artist that we're going to be working with today is Jackson Pollock. He is a motion painter. Yes, a motion painter. That kind of creates some angst to some of you parents, I'm sure, because Jackson Pollock can make a mess. I'm going to show you some easy steps to enjoy Jackson Pollock in a safe environment. So, with a piece of paper, white, plain, colored, whatever you would like, we're going to get started on creating Jackson Pollock. Now, Jackson Pollock, he stirred up a big controversy in the art community because he took his canvas and he laid it on the floor and he just took house paint and started pouring and dripping and splattering it. To most people, it looked like a giant mess. But to Pollock, he said each dribble, each splatter was carefully placed. So we're gonna practice just like Jackson Pollock and make sure that everything is carefully placed. I'm gonna use a skewer, actually. And I tied a string to it, and I'm going to place it in some paint. I take the string. I can use the end of the stick to kind of dip it in there. I watered down the paint so it's easier to move. If it's kind of clumpy, it's not going to move so well. So if you don't have a stick, you can always use a paper clip. Or I'm sorry, not a paper clip, a clothesline clip. And just clip that right on the end. And voila! Jackson Pollock at its finest. Make sure your yarn is in the paint. And now you can just take the string out and let it move across the paper. And as you do that, it creates a Jackson Pollock-like painting. Put that back in. Now when I get another color, it'll mix and blend and hopefully create new colors. Voila. I have some jazz playing in the background because that's what Jackson Pollock loved. He loved painting to jazz. Now, if you don't have any sticks and yarn available to you, there's some other cool things that you can use at home. We can use food coloring. Yep, just your regular old food coloring. I added a little water to it, like so, and you can use either an eyedropper or a straw, whichever you like. Let me get a new piece of paper here. So I can take my eyedropper, squeeze it, put it into the paint, suck up some paint, or I'm sorry, food dye, and splatter it. Get some more. Make sure you're doing this in a tray and you've covered your area with a nice placemat. after you take your eyedropper. If you don't have an eyedropper, you can, like I said, use just a regular straw. Put your straw, one end of it, into the dye or food coloring. Put your other finger over top and let the splatters splat. Then you can blow. And there we have another type of Jackson Pollock art. You can also take a toothbrush, an old toothbrush, might I add, stick it into your food coloring and just run your finger over top and let it almost spray onto your art. Again, keeping it contained. You can also, if you don't have a straw available to you, you can pick up your paper and move it around from side to side, making for some unusual drips and drags. If you don't have an eyedropper or food dye, but maybe you have some marbles, maybe a lid to a box, I recommend this next one. This is my favorite. So I have a box lid. I'm going to take a marble or a round ball, and I'm going to put them right into the paint. And I'm going to use a spoon to take them out. And you want to grab some paint with it too, so that way they can move around. If you have some extra ones, by all means, take some extra marbles or little round balls, put them in there. And then if you just move the box lid around, it'll make a very interesting Jackson Pollock picture. And you don't want to make those marbles or little BBs fall out, because then it makes a mess. So you got to keep your marbles in your box. Got to hold on to them so you don't lose them. And as you move them around, they mix and create some new colors. And here you are experimenting and creating Jackson Pollock in a very safe environment without making a mess like Jackson did. So, that's our Jackson Pollock lesson for the day. Remember, you can use sticks with yarn in attached and move the paint across the paper. You can use paper clips or clothesline clips. You can also use an eyedropper to grab some paint or some dye, and use a straw to move that paint around. But remember, make sure you take care of your space and you clean up and put your supplies away. And if any one of these techniques didn't work for you, try it again. Practice, practice, practice. So, thank you for joining us today with Jackson Pollock and my art groupies. Till next time.